Oh my gosh, you guys, right before I got on here, I was opening the boxes that I'm going to do a haul for, and one of them was a surprise. It wasn't what I was expecting, so it's really, I'm even more excited. So we'll get to that in just a minute, but real quickly, I just had some information I read about yesterday in an email, and I don't know if you're signed up for Tuesday morning emails, but basically their CEO put out an email saying that they are filing for Chapter 11 bankruptcy, and I mean, that's not the worst thing in the world, right? Because usually that just means reorganization. And I mean, you guys, I mean, basically at this point, that was, I think, was expected. On top of that, you know, Tuesday morning is kind of a strange little place to go, but I always like that they have such quirky things. But unfortunately, with that Chapter 11 bankruptcy and reorganization, they are closing several stores, they said. So I don't know of their underperforming stores, which is odd. Out here in San Diego or this area, I have two that are kind of near each other. One's in a smaller town, Vista, and I like that one. There's another one in Oceanside that's not my favorite, but, so who knows? I mean, I don't know, obviously, I don't know the numbers or what they bring in, but that'll be pretty unfortunate, but I just want to let you guys know in case you're keeping that eye out on your Tuesday morning. I know a lot of people say, oh, they're opening, and I'm going, and I'm like, eh, I will go when it's safe to go. I don't, just because something's open doesn't mean we're going or I'm going, especially right now. So that's a real bummer. But if you do, you know, decide to go out there, just be safe, please. You know, whatever that means to you. And for me, it's wearing a mask and just like washing your hands super well when you get home and having your Purell or whatever and all that kind of stuff. But I only do that because I basically go to the grocery store and that's about it. So for now. But yeah, so that's unfortunate. So I did want to give you guys that information just to give you a heads up because maybe you weren't aware of that. And yeah, that's too bad. And I was wondering where these overstocked things might go, maybe like TJ Maxx or Ross, even more than they already have. Because they used to have a lot of like crafty stuff, right? And they kind of started getting less and less, but so that's that. One other update real quick is I, you know, used that watercolor paper the other day, that Crafter's Companion paper. That was a huge mess on this, for this particular application, right? I used the Arteza markers and they just did not blend on there. It was horrible. The paper started feathering and like peeling really fast, which lets you know you can't blend very well on this paper, right? I mean, that's the whole point of watercolor paper. And then I thought, well, maybe it's like cotton based or maybe something, but no, it doesn't say anything funky. It just says premium watercolor paper. And I just brought the card just to remind you guys. What that kind of looked like. And in here, you can see it better when it tore, when I used the tape. And it's just, you know, it's okay. But it, look at all the feathering and bleeding, you know, just the color, right? So I didn't want to give up on that paper because I figured we can use it for backgrounds and blending that way, right? Because you just throw some color on or spray it on with like your sprays, your oxides. So later I tried a piece with some of my new little stamps from Art Impressions, because a lot of times, like I said, you know, I can't really film everything anymore like I used to. If I was going to do something, I got it on film, right, on camera, if it was anything crafty. But now with the kids home, like, when I want to play with my stuff, like, I can't, I don't have enough time to just make videos every time. So I play with this. It's a little crooked, but pretty cute. This is the same paper. Now with this one, you don't really do blending. You're just stamping, and then you kind of draw some color out with a little bit of water, right? So it's not the biggest deal, and the Tombows always melt down pretty quick. So it worked pretty well for that application, I think. Not bad. And then I started messing around with other things. So this is still, is this the same paper? No, this is actually, this is just a regular watercolor paper that came in this watercolor card. So I'm just showing you guys this just for some info. So this is Crafter's Companion 300 GSM, which is pretty great. It says high quality, smooth, professional watercolor board. It is smooth, but it's not smooth, like flat. It has some grain to it. On the backside, it's a little bit smoother, but no, it's still pretty bumpy. I mean, for me, smooth is smooth, right? Because they do have smooth cardstock or watercolor paper. So these stamps are from that Elizabeth Crafts. I totally wanted to play with them, and I got in there. And you guys, I don't know what I'm doing here. I just threw down some color and tried to blend it out. I tried to work with like a darker skin tone on this one. This one was just to play around. And I used the Arteza brushes. And they blended really well. With this one, I had to add more water to kind of blend out her skin and stuff. And even though they look funky because I don't know what I'm doing, I think it came out pretty good. I had stamped it originally and it didn't stamp well, so I just flipped over the paper. But see, I added more water to this one. You can see it's kind of wonky. It's a little bit messed up, right? And then this side I did less water and it's pretty good. It's okay. So I'm probably gonna mess with this a little more, but these are the Arteza brushes. Hopefully I can do a review with the company soon, but until then I'll probably do a review of these separately. I've used them a few times, but not really like a tutorial like this is how to use these because I don't know anything. But since I've been playing with them, I learned a lot, and I think as crafters, that's what we want, right? You want to throw this into your like your junk journal or do something without a card really quickly or on an envelope, but you don't have to be, it doesn't have to be a masterpiece, just something, right? So that's the 48 piece. I think I got it from Amazon, but to be honest, Arteza themselves have tons of really good sales on their site, but I cannot recommend them yet because I've never ordered from them, so I don't really feel comfortable saying, you know, oh, they do this well or that. So until I do, I'll recommend them later if that's the case, but for right now, I'm just showing you those brush pens. And they came out pretty good. And the stamps, again, are from Elizabeth Craft Designs. And then I realized I think I have some watercolor paper from Arteza. So I looked on Amazon to see my old orders. And sure enough, when I ordered these pens, I had ordered paper. But I'm like, where did I put them? So I came in my room. I'm like, where could they be? And then in my head, it popped in. I'm like, oh, I remember I was trying to put, like, specialty papers all together. And I looked. And sure enough, they were there. I didn't even realize I had three packs of this because it's a set of three that were like $11 on Amazon. So 30 sheets of the watercolor pad. It says premium, acid-free, cold press paper, and the spiral bound. And good for mixed media and watercolor techniques. And then join the Arteza Club and get 20% off. I don't know. It has different things. Their website has a blog feature. You know, you can click on blog and they have so many ideas, you guys. I really recommend checking them out. At least for now, check out their website with their blog. So I started kind of messing around. So yesterday I did this. I did this earlier in the day, and then I was like hooked because you don't even need to have anything with you. Just this with the water brush that's in there. And I just sat down and was just drawing while I was watching news. And Dorian, he's so cute. He said he liked this one better than this. And I did this freehand just out of my brain because I was like, I don't know what to do. I don't know how to do this stuff. So I just did a little something. So really fun. Obviously, I'll learn more skills as I go along, but like, super basic. And then this girl, I just went with some blue hair and did something fun. And again, this is the same pen, though. That's what's interesting about these papers or anything in general. This is the same pen for the skin tone. So like, how do, you know, it came out so different, but that's what happens. So hopefully I'll have some videos for you guys soon. I know you guys, a lot of you guys commented when you saw the last haul with the Elizabeth Crafts Design stuff that you want to see those girls in action. And they are really fun and very simple to color in. So the brushes, the brush pens, I'm a huge fan. I need to try them out on regular paper. Oh, you know what? That's a lie. I did try them out on regular paper already. So let me show you one more little... This all should go in a review. I don't know why I'm talking about it right now. This is just the markers, just used as markers. Or the brush pens used as markers. And it's fine, you know? I was gonna make a little project and it didn't work out for me, so anyway. this is also the brush pens, but I did wet the blue around the edge. So, you know, they're markers. You can use them as markers, you can wet them a little bit, you can do whatever, but this is just regular stamping paper, and they worked real well on there. So, again, hopefully I'll have a review for you guys very soon, but let's get started with the haul. Really quickly, the other day when I had to go by the Dollar Tree to see if I can find some foam to show you guys how to use the foam to make 3D embossing on your marquee. Since they didn't have that, they did have this cute stuff though, so I went ahead and picked this up. Little tubes of washi or little 5-piece washies. Kind of reminds me of the kind of thing you would order from like AliExpress where they're kind of inexpensive and just little thin strips. So this one's really cute with the little glitter and the little like rainbow paper is what my favorite was there. On this one, I picked up two because I'm like, oh my gosh, the little cactuses. I don't know if you can see. The little cactuses. Super adorable and the little hearts. So a little green colorway kind of. And then the glitter one, that's really nice. And this one, I just like the, again, I thought this one kind of goes with the cactuses. There's black. Actually, the black one has like video game things. I didn't notice. I don't know if you can see that. Really cute. And then the blue shimmery and foil. So I thought these were adorable, so I grabbed those. That is all to show you from there. Oh, okay. So I had ordered this stuff. This is from Stampers Anonymous, which I've never ordered before, like, directly. But we had a discount code from that Great Lakes Mega Meat. And here's all their tags, I don't know. Actually, I think it's called Art Gone Wild and Friends, but when you click on there, it says Stampers Anonymous. Like, that's their... I don't know. I'll have the... I don't remember exactly the... what's that called? The name of the website. I thought it was... I'll have it here. Yeah, it says Argon Wild on the side, but interesting. We will see. Maybe it is Argon Wild, but they like sell the Stampers Anonymous stuff. Anyhow, I ordered this a while ago, whenever I showed you guys those discounts in that one video, because what happened is I signed up for their Tim Holtz new distress color of the month or something. It's the May new color bundle. And so they had to wait until that came in, or that was released, for them to send my stuff. So this is one of the stamp sets I picked up in the meantime with them. Super cute. I just thought these are adorable. It reminds me of like Where the Wild Things Are kind of drawings. It's called Snarky Cat CMS392. I mean, they're just funny. Like, look, I'm not saying that you're old, but if you were milk, I'd sniff you first and stuff like that. I know right from wrong. Wrong is the fun one. Don't judge me. Hey, train wreck, this isn't your station. Just a bunch of cute little things, little sayings on there. And I just like the little characters. Super cute. They also have them in individual stamps, but this, I think, was $20 or so. You know, the Stampers Anonymous kits are normally like $20. those kind. Yeah. $22-ish. And then I picked up just some fun stuff because I don't have a lot of Ranger things and I want to get into doing some more fun kind of things. But these are just little jars of Distress Micro Glaze, which I was interested in trying out, which is this one. Wait. Yeah, it's this one. Embossing powder and super fine clear, frosted crystal, and sticky embossing powder. So they all have their purposes and their uses. They're just embossing powders for now is all I picked up. But pretty cool. Again, I had that discount. And then this is our Tim Holtz Distress Ink Mystery Ink. So let's open this up. Although they did release it. So I was going to say, I'm going to cut it from the bottom because I don't want to cut that because that's how I am. So let me cut it in this bottom part. And so this is the new color for May. And you know, I mean, I have my Tim Holtz stuff. I'm not like a huge, hey, I got to get this. But I just thought this was really fun. So like, why not? So let's see what it would have looked like if I had cut it open from the top. It looked like this. It has a little fluff in there. So this is a new color called Speckled Egg. And when I saw it, when I finally got an email from Stampers Anonymous, and I was like, ooh, let me go look and see if they show the color. I was like, this is really pretty. I don't feel like, oh, I shouldn't have gotten, you know, this whole kit. Because it's basically everything in his lineup in that color. So it comes with a cute little pin, right? I forgot what the name of these pins are. I think you call it a tile or a chip or whatever, but it's basically a pin with that cute, oh my gosh, what's that called? It starts with an M. No, it doesn't. Does it? I'll think about it. We have Speckled Egg Distress Ink, Speckled Egg Distress Oxide. You can see it's a really pretty color that kind of matches my surface here, but it looks like a very light color. Enamel, that's the word I'm thinking of. Distress Embossing Glaze and Speckled Egg. This is really pretty. Just a really pretty little jar of something. So what's a bummer is I was planning on doing some reviews of this. Well, not this one because I didn't realize this was coming. But the stuff that came in from HSN. But my delivery guy got here at 8:45 last night. And I was like, well, it's too late now. So hopefully I'll have some reviews starting up today of some of the items that just came in. Distress Oxide Spray, which I am really starting to love. Oh, there's a warning on there. I wonder what's in there that makes that warning be there. I'll have to check it out. Distress Spray Stains. This is just your color. We have Distress Oxide in the little dropper. We have Distress Paint. All in the same color. And then, is this the ink drops? Yeah, Distress Ink. So pretty cool. I mean, I'm going to have a lot of fun with this stuff. I mean, obviously I have it all blue, but it's a nice lineup. So I'm glad to have all this fun stuff here. So pretty cool, and that again came from Stampers Anonymous, which I will have the link for, because like I said, I thought it was called Stampers Anonymous, but oh well. Oopsie. Oh, I dropped everything. I put it all back in the box nice, and it just fell. Okay, so a couple other things. So HSN, I have been stalking their site for a long time, and I know a lot of you guys have too, and I mentioned this the other day without even showing them. You guys went over and bought them. So last year, around this time, maybe a little bit earlier, Diamond Press had a auto ship for these cute little shakers when they came out with their shakers. So these are small. You know, the new one is bigger, obviously, for the marquee. But these are super cute, and I've been stocking them. So this one makes like a little party hat, the little cupcake, or I guess you can make it into an ice cream cone. You know, maybe we'll see. I might do something fun with that. because this is the one I was really, really looking forward to. And then the balloon. And this one is called, and it always comes with, you know, the little confettis you can make and then everything to make your shakers. Oh, the little gift. Oh, the gift box too. How cute. So this one has four different shakers, really. The gift box is over here. So this one is, I think it's called Celebration, but I don't remember. Yeah, so it's the Shaker Die Celebration Kit. And then this one's Something Splendid Shaker Kit. So I pretty much just grabbed all three. I think there was a coupon last week sometime, so I picked them up. So this one has like a little jar, which is super cute. It has like a fish tank. And then it has this piece here that makes, that goes with this one over here. It makes like a gumball machine. So it has like a little gumball machine. And then it has little shapes you can cut. Little fishies and little dots. How cute is that? So I'm going to review these probably later today because I really wanted to get going on these. I think it's fun. And this one's the Fall Harvest. And then there's another one, I think it has Summertime or Vacation Time or something like that. And I already bought that one, but it has like little sunglasses and other cute little items. So that's another one. And so I have that one too. I already got that one previously though. This one has the confetti's like little leaves that are super cute. Oh my gosh, the little leaf even has like a little, like the stem part to it. Plus like a leaf that's a little more fall looking. This has little pumpkins. So there's a pumpkin in here. There's an acorn, a leaf. And it looked like an apple to me, but maybe it's an apple or a pumpkin. I don't know. In the picture, I thought it was an apple. So there's more shapes back here. So we will definitely review these and try these out later today. But I just want to let you know, just in case you're curious and want to get that going. Last thing that might be kind of quick, maybe take a little time, is Nailite. So Nailite, I always bought my acrylic, not always, but whenever I started doing more acrylics, I used to get my stuff from them. They have lots of supplies for manicuring and things like that, right? So beauty shop kind of stuff. You don't have to have a license to buy from them. They're from Florida there, and you can just order whatever you want to order. Now, they brought back their hand sanitizer. So they have gel hand sanitizer, they have spray hand sanitizer, which, you know, usually when you go to the shop, they spray your hands. So the gel one, I'm like, ooh, I might need to get some. Because even at this point, I do not have hand sanitizer. Like, when I go to the store, I don't just see it, you know, on the shelves. They don't ask for, like, too much money, I don't think, in my opinion. But, and then they also have the 99% alcohol I've told you guys about. And then they're selling masks, which that one, it's okay, the pricing on that. But if you can't find masks, then that's a good place, you know, to order them. So the hand sanitizer, like I said, was not super expensive, but I was surprised to see that they're all in little bottles like this. But actually, in a way, that's kind of nice, because I was like, how are you going to have a hand sanitizer in such a huge bottle? Because it said, like, a gallon. And the gallon, I'm like, how am I going to dispense from a gallon into a little hand, you know, a smaller one? Or it just seemed like a mess. So I ordered the smaller size. Oh, man, I don't have the packaging slip, which is weird. You always put a packaging slip in here. So I'm surprised that they're like this, but this is how they are. So these hand sanitizers, and they still have them in stock. And then please, if you go and they're out of stock, it's not my fault. Last time a lot of people were like, there's no more alcohol, like kind of rude coming back and telling me comments. And I'm like, I don't own the company. Like, how do I know? But I just saw an email right now before I logged on here to make this video that their alcohol is back in stock. So, and then these little ones. So these are all, I guess it adds up to the size of what I ordered because it was 8, 8, but I do like it in a smaller bottle or container. So that is not a problem for me. I didn't buy the gallon, like I said. I think I bought the half of a gallon. So that's kind of what we have here, the equivalent. I did pick up some Omega monomer because it's not always in stock. And since it was a stock, I grabbed it. But this is just the monomer I used to go with my acrylic stuff. And to get, you know, free shipping, you know, I was kind of close. And so I was like, well, I really, really, really like their cuticle oils. And this one's pineapple and this one's peach. I already have a peach one. But these are only like $4. But, oh, it smells so good. So, again, just have different things that have to do with manicuring. But they also sell these in smaller bottles. I just know that the 4-ounce globe thing is my jam. So I picked up that size. And then we have some lint-free wipes, again, for, you know, doing your nails, different purposes that I need that for. These are only like $1, so I basically added this just so I can get to $69 for free shipping. Otherwise, I think the shipping's only like $6 or $7 anyway, but, you know. So it's just a manicure bowl. And then they have this lineup of stuff that I've never tried, these polishes or gel polishes. These are just polish, so I did want to try them. They're Agatha Ruiz de la Prada, I don't know. And I have colors glitter fuchsia and eggplant. And the glitter fuchsia, hope you can see, has that little kind of shimmer to it, and the eggplant color is nice and just like a nice purple, but maybe more raspberry, I don't know. Really pretty. Brush on gel, glue gel, because they have really nice, it's called resin, but good stuff. And some manicure sticks. And then these are super inexpensive, and I always like to try new cuticle pushers. So this is a cuticle pusher, which again, I like to mix glitter with. I use this to actually pick out like acrylic. They have different purposes. And then the other side has like a little poker. So you can check them out. Again, like I said, they're always restocking, or pretty much it seems like they always have things in stock now. I did see my local like Mexican market had some hand sanitizers like this in. It was about this amount, and they wanted $16 for it. And I'm like, really? Like, come on. And then when I went to return something at UPS, they also had, again, kind of a weird big bottle of a brand you never heard of, and they wanted $14.99. I was like, these people, no. So hopefully that helps you guys out if you are still looking for things like that. And thanks for watching. Keep an eye out. I will be using these fun things hopefully very soon. The Arteza kind of review and kind of talking about using papers and different things like that. Everyone's recommending Bristol. Supposedly everyone recommends Bristol. But you know what? The watercolor paper, I don't see what the big deal is if you just use watercolor paper. But I guess Bristol paper kind of makes a nice card because it's smooth, right? So if you're just going to paint on it and have your card, that's probably a better application for what we do, right? But I will have some other things coming up. I am ordering more from Elizabeth Crafts Designs. Well, I did order more. I ordered a planner, a fuchsia one. Because at first I was like, well, I'll just try out some of her stuff. And I really like the stamps, and I really like, you know, her little videos and things. So I was like, I guess I'll get it. But my plan would be not really to use a planner, but more like a junk journal. And so I ordered a couple of the page dies. She has tons of page dies for the journal. I ordered a couple different sets, and then like some more stamps and like other little dies to go with it. So I figure I just need a few things to get it going, right? So I ordered very basic things. Another gal here had mentioned that if you want to order her stuff at great prices, to go to Hochanda, Hochanda, and I guess they're selling to the U.S. again, or shipping to the U.S. Well, I've never ordered from them, so but that's a tip, so I just want to let you guys know. And yeah, let's get going. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye now.